To find how many fields have missing values, we can do a few things. Personally, my favorite thing to do when I bring a file in is to immediately run the field summary tool on it to see details about the data. I'll add the tool in, add browses to it, and run the workflow. If we look at the interactive output, we can open the window from the browser, and we can immediately see that there are missing values across several fields by the red part in this line here. There are missing data in all of the fields except for the client ID field. If we expand, we can see more details about the fields. To actually remove the blank value records from the dataset, we add a filter tool and filter where the value of contract field is not null. And then we do the same for the industry and the average number of tickets fields. And then we add one more filter tool for the last variable, which is number of employees. We also need to make sure that this is not null. And when we run the workflow, we see that we have 175 records remaining. Another way to count the number of records that come out of the true side is to add a tool called Count Records. And when we run the workflow, the number of records passing through is shown here, 175. Next, we'll add the scatter plot tools to the workflow, one for all of the data, and the second for the data with missing values removed. And then we'll run the results out to browse window and look at the two scatter plots side by side. In looking at the two scatter plots side by side, we can tell that by looking at the y-axis, that the slope of the line has definitely changed. The scatter plot on the left contains all of the data. And as you can see on the y-axis, the slope goes up and over 100 number of tickets. Whereas on the right side, the scatter plot is of the data with the missing values removed. We can roughly calculate the slope of each line from the scatter plots. With all of the data, we can use the points along the x-axis for 200 and 100 employees. With 200 employees, the average number of tickets with all the data is approximately 20 tickets. With 1,000 employees, the average number of tickets is approximately 105. The slope is equal to the change in y divided by the change in x. The slope of the line is approximately 105 minus 20 divided by 1,000 minus 200, or 85 over 800, which is 0.11. Using the same method for the scatter plot with the missing values removed, we can see that the average number of tickets for 1,000 employees is approximately 40, and for 200 employees, that number is approximately 25. Therefore, the slope is equal to 40 minus 25 divided by 1,000 minus 200, or 15 over 800, which is 0.02. The slope of the line has definitely decreased. Let's see if another imputation method will be better for our analysis.